Frankenstein, and I want to know what the fuck you're doing with my time.
April 27, 2006, writer and director Adam Green would give bloodthirsty fans a much-needed fix of old-school American horror. It's not a remake, it's not a sequel, and it's not based on a Japanese one. Victor Crawley lives in the unapologetic splatterfest Hatchet. Welcome to the Gore Store. Ben is a bit of a dork who just got dumped by his girlfriend. Him and his boys are in Louisiana for Mardi Gras. Ben is having the absolute worst experience while his best friend Marcus is having the time of his life. Ben's squad is the shit. One guy is definitely a couple cans short of a six pack. While Marcus is ecstatic for some titties, Ben decides to go on his own towards the haunted swamp tour he just happens to know about. Of course, to his dismay, Marcus decides to follow his boy. Soon enough, they meet Reverend Zombie. One of my favorite characters is played brilliantly by the horror icon Tony Todd. This is some dark shit.
Two eyes staring at him from the woods, chilled him to his very marrow. They wanted to get off the boat in a hurry. And he had his foot dangling over the edge.
He fell in?
A gator got him?
What happened?
He slipped. Hit his head right on the roof. And sued me for negligence. That cocksucker!
That's it?
Soon enough, Ben and Marcus arrive at the next best swamp tour in town. Here, we meet the rest of the cast. Jenna and Misty are conned into a Bayou Beavers production by the very shady Doug Shapiro. If you like TNA, these are the two characters for you. Sean is the mastermind behind the shitty boat ride that may or may not be legit. Once on the bus, we meet the rest of the gang, including the elder couple Jim and Shannon, along with the mystery girl Mary Beth. After soon arriving at the boat, our group meets a haggard fisherman appropriately named Jack Cracker, who drinks his own piss. The Vagabond, played by horror makeup effects and horror director Carl Buxler, he warned this group to stay out of the swamp because it's cursed. They went anyway, naturally. Ben tries his best with Mary Beth, but he's fucking terrible. We soon learn Sean is full of shit and that Mary Beth paid $10 less, but not before the boat smashes into a nearby island. With the boat slowly sinking, Jim is attacked by a hungry gator. Mary Beth pulls out a pistol and fires at the son of a bitch. With Jim hurt and the group lost, they soon learn the curse of Victor Crowley is all too real. Mary Beth tells the story of a deformed child living in hiding in an old house deep in the Louisiana swamp. Children would often make fun of the poor child until one night a prank goes horribly wrong. The house is accidentally set on fire as the child's father rushes to his son's aid. In a panic, the father smashes the burning door with a sharp hatchet, not realizing his kid had his face pressed to the other side. The hatchet rips into the boy's skull and kills him instantly. The father would grief for his son for his remaining years until he passed. He would grief for Victor Crowley. Big shout out to Kane Hodder, who plays Victor Crowley but also played his dad. He did a good job. With Shannon screaming for help, the couple made the poor choice of heading towards the old Crowley house. Like a demon in the night, Victor Crowley emerges and holy shit, is this motherfucker scary. One after the other, he obliterates Jim to smithereens before completely tearing Shannon's fucking skull from her jaw. The rest of the group run off in terror as Mary Beth fires shots at Crowley. Doug Shapiro separates from the group like an idiot, so naturally he got what he deserved. His death, you can fucking feel. The rest of the survivors regroup and convince Marcus to follow them back to the old dilapidated house to arm themselves. Here, Mary Beth finds the mangled corpses of her father and brother, Samson and Ainsley, the two fishermen from back in the beginning of the cold open. This is why Mary Beth came to the swamps to begin with. Meanwhile, Sean, Jenna, and Misty fight off a ferocious raccoon before being surprised by an angry Victor Crowley. Jenna's beautiful face is turned into hamburger meat as Sean intervenes. Sean is then brutally decapitated as Jenna is impaled like a shish kebab.
Fatality.
With only 4 survivors left, our heroes finally decide to lure Victor out. Ben frantically searches the gasoline tanks as Misty stands guard. Marcus and Mary Beth act as bait, hurling childish insults and calling out Crowley himself. As Ben finally finds fresh gasoline, Misty's head is violently flung at poor Ben. Ben freaks out as Misty's body parts reunite by his muddy feet. Victor Crowley growls viciously before getting drenched in the little gas that was left in the dirty tank by Ben. Marcus and Mary Beth waste little time igniting Victor on fire. Ironically, it begins to rain and the fire charring Victor Crowley's skin is soon extinguished. Our 3 survivors, now even more frustrated, get out of Dodge. Marcus is soon caught and completely fucking mutilated. Ben stops short and begins to vomit over the loss of his best friend Marcus. Like a bat out of hell, Victor Crowley charges towards Ben and Mary Beth. They both improvise and vigorously impale Victor one final time. I mean, Ben is in complete shambles at this point. He all fucked up. Mary Beth consoles Ben as they both commandeer a nearby boat and escape into the night. During their tranquil boat ride, both Ben and Mary Beth try their hardest to be there for one another. Both severely hurt, mentally and physically. The worst is over. The boogeyman is dead and all is well. It's kind of rare that a splatterfest like Hatchet ends in such a lighthearted— oh shit! This motherfucker Victor Crowley is back and takes Mary Beth deep into the murky water. Ben, with all that he has left, reaches out to Mary Beth from above the calm waves. Mary Beth reaches hard for Ben and finds his reach. The fighter grabs Ben's hand but quickly realizes it has been severely amputated. At this point, Ben is like several levels fucked up. The film ends with Victor Crowley screaming like a banshee, looking directly into the viewer's eyes, proclaiming, "Horror is fucking back." Thank you for joining us on another episode of Horror Fiend Drive-In Theater. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like on the way out. And please subscribe to the channel for more horror content like this for horror fans like you. I'm Ricky Grimes. Support Hatchet. Support Victor Crowley. Support horror. Most of all, stay scared.